Hello students, today we are going to perform the oxidation reaction. In this, first is oxidation of benzyl alcohol, and you know obviously if you oxidize benzyl alcohol, the product is going to be benzoic acid. Okay, so this is the structure of benzyl alcohol. We are going to use potassium permanganate as oxidizing agent, which itself is going to get reduced to form manganese dioxide. At the same time, your benzyl alcohol is going to get oxidized to benzoic acid. Okay? And since the reaction media is having potassium ions, it is obviously going to be in ionized state to give COO minus K plus. So it is just going to form ionic bond with potassium ions, which in presence of HCl will get converted to the free acid. This is the salt form, so this can be called as potassium benzoate. Side product which is formed, as I told you, potassium permanganate is acting like an oxidizing agent, but it itself will get reduced to give manganese dioxide. So this is manganese dioxide. And the final product after neutralization with HCl or treatment with HCl, what you get is benzoic acid along with the formation of potassium chloride as side product. Okay, so we will look at the reaction now, how to perform first. Okay, so as per procedure, I have taken 60 ml of water. To this, I am going to add 3-weighed quantity of potassium permanganate, that is 3 g. And just to prevent bumping and uniform heating, I am going to add a porcelain piece to this conical flask, and I am going to place this into a boiling water bath. The water bath has not started to boil yet, so we will have to keep it on boiling water bath for 2-3 minutes. Okay?
So initially I heated on water bath, but it is taking time, so I am heating it directly using tongs. You have to heat it to boiling. Then just have a look, the solution is about to boil now. So after boiling, we have to place this aside for 2-3 minutes and then add benzyl alcohol. So you can see the solution has started boiling. I am going to stop heating and place it aside for 2-3 minutes. To this, now I am going to add benzyl alcohol 2 ml. And I am going to stir the reaction mixture. You can just look at the color of the mixture now. It is almost brown, so that indicates that the potassium permanganate has completely got reduced to manganese dioxide. So this brown colored PPT is your manganese dioxide, and this indicates that the oxidation reaction is completed. Now we will filter this solution. We want the filtrate, the precipitate, whatever we have got brown colored, that is of manganese dioxide. So we will separate the manganese dioxide and we should get a clear filtrate. Okay. So you can see the filtration assembly is ready. Filtration flask, the rubber teat above which there is a Buckner funnel. And I have kept the filter paper Now I'm just going to wet this filter paper so that the filtration occurs fast, because you know manganese dioxide, it tends to stick and form a cake of thin particles, very small particles. So it forms a fine particle cake and it is very difficult to filter. So I'm just wetting the filter paper and I'll just throw this water, whatever is there. Now I'll start with the vacuum. Remember, we want the filtrate over here. I'll just pour this solution, whatever we have got. You can see below, you're not getting a very clear filtrate, but we can filter it, refilter it to get a clear filtrate. For now, we will continue filtering through the manganese dioxide cake. See, the filter cake is of very fine particles, so that is why there is hardly any gap for the solution to go. Though I have applied a lot of vacuum, still the filtration rate is very, very slow. You see, speed has still gone down, the filtration rate, because now you have a very thick cake of manganese dioxide. So now I have completed the filtration. You can see we have got a fairly clear solution, though colored one. And this is the manganese dioxide cake. I'm given washings with water also. As per the procedure. Now since the filtrate which we have got have some particles of manganese dioxide, you can see. So I'm refiltering it by normal filtration. And now you can see the filtrate. It is much clearer than what we got earlier. Right? You can just compare the color as well. So this filtrate we are going to use, it contains your potassium salt of benzoic acid, that is potassium benzoate, and we will just convert it to the free form of benzoic acid by simply acidification. When you add HCl to the potassium benzoate, you will get back your benzoic acid as a precipitate. Okay. So this is our filtrate and this is the concentrated HCl. I am simply going to acidify the filtrate. And you can see, as soon as I have added acid, you could see some precipitate formation. So that is nothing but your benzoic acid. I'll just add little bit of more acid so that if there is any traces of potassium benzoate to be converted, it will get converted. So you're getting the formation of benzoic acid precipitation, right? This benzoic acid you will filter again at pump. Again, my filtration assembly is ready. So I am just going to wet the filter paper And now, because I don't want the filtrate, my final compound is going to be the crystals on filter paper. So to this only I will pour my filtrate, which is having precipitate of benzoic acid. You can just give washings with water, because you know benzoic acid is insoluble in water, so we can give enough washings and dry the crude product on the Buckner funnel itself. The compound is having a slight pinkish brownish color, probably because of the manganese dioxide. So we can just add charcoal during the recrystallization process. So this is the synthesized crude benzoic acid. Now we can recrystallize it using water as solvent, because you know benzoic acid, it is insoluble in water at room temperature. At the same time, at hot high temperature, that is at the boiling point of water, benzoic acid dissolves. So water is a suitable recrystallization solvent for recrystallization of benzoic acid. Now this recrystallization we have performed in the organic chemistry practicals last time, so you can go through my another video which is there on YouTube for benzoic acid recrystallization. And then after recrystallization we will get fine needle shaped crystals, pure crystals of benzoic acid. During the process, because there is a slight brownish color, we can give charcoal treatment just before the hot filtration. And then after cooling, we will get the crystals which will filter, give washings with cold water, dry the compound properly, determine the melting point, then weigh the compound, find the practical yield, that is weighing of the compound. Then after theoretical yield calculation, we can calculate the percent practical yield and finish the experiment. Just like oxidation of benzyl alcohol gives us benzoic acid, we can even perform the oxidation reaction of toluene to give the same product, because toluene is one oxidation state behind of benzyl alcohol. So toluene on oxidation gives benzoic acid. The oxidizing agent is the same, that is we use potassium permanganate, and after that we get the potassium salt of benzoic acid, that is potassium benzoate, which we need to acidify the filtrate and get the benzoic acid in free form. So either of these reactions, that is oxidation of benzyl alcohol or oxidation of toluene, can give me benzoic acid. So this reaction is started. You can see in round bottom flask, a solution of potassium permanganate 6 gram was prepared in water 70 ml, and then toluene was added 1.5 ml, and the reaction mixture was refluxed for about 4 hours. So why this reaction is taking more time is because we are going from toluene to benzoic acid. Going from benzyl alcohol to benzoic acid is much simpler as compared to the oxidation reaction of toluene to get benzoic acid, because benzyl alcohol, as per the oxidation state, the benzyl alcohol is much easier to oxidize than benzoic acid, because it is already having an oxygen, right? It is C6, what you can say, benzene ring with a CH2OH, benzyl alcohol. So obviously the time required is much more for oxidation of toluene. It is taking 4 hours, while for our benzyl alcohol oxidation, we have seen it just took 2 to 3 minutes of heating, and then just addition of benzyl alcohol and the potassium permanganate brought about the oxidation, got converted to manganese dioxide, and we got our product, which was then filtered. The manganese dioxide cake was filtered, we got the filtrate, and then we acidified to get the benzoic acid in free form. Okay, so either of the procedures can be used. Same workup is done for oxidation of toluene also. Now after 4 hours, the reaction mixture is switched off, the reflux is switched off, it is filtered similar to the benzyl alcohol procedure, and the rest follows. Okay, so with this we have completed with 2 experiments. Actually this is an OR experiment, but because the benzyl alcohol conversion to benzoic acid takes less time and also the yield is better, we are going to perform only the oxidation of benzyl alcohol to benzoic acid. Thank you.